I've made quite a few videos about the Mercury playback engine and the problems when using track mats, and I've narrowed the problem down. It's definitely a bug with Adobe Premiere Pro. As you can see, if I hit play, you can see that the track mat's freaking out. Adobe software doesn't know what to do with it. See, I'm just moving it around. It keeps wanting to rescale itself. This is not how the software should actually work. However, if I go into highest quality and then I hit playback, as everybody can see, now it's playing back just fine. We're not getting those huge jumps. If I scale down, if I move it, it's not resizing itself. But the problem is, if you're in the highest quality, it kind of wants to lock up too. It's not going to actually give you as many track layers. So if you're trying to do like 3 or 4 layers of track mats, it's just not going to work for you. I have a GTX 650 Ti and a quad core Haswell. Some people might say, hey, just go out and get an 8-core CPU and a GTX 980 Ti and you'll probably have just as many layers, you know, setting it in high quality, you know. But that's really shouldn't be the way the software works. I mean, I'm going to go back, undo the high quality, and now we're seeing the jump. I mean, it should work great in high quality or however you want to have it. There shouldn't be this huge discrepancy. Also, like I showed in my other video, if I go into software-only mode, that does away with the problem right off the bat. As you can see, I unselected high-quality playback, but you're not seeing it freaking out. If I slide this around and see it, it's not freaking out at all. So yeah, the GPU acceleration works good for some things. Software works better for other things. But like I said, I could just play it in software mode and get as many real-time special effects. I shouldn't have to put it in highest quality playback. It is a nice feature for Adobe to put that feature in there because it does actually play back a little bit better if you're in high quality, but you lose a lot of real-time performance too. While I'm talking about problems with Premiere Pro, I want to recap the problem with this 3D perspective filter. Everything's coming out okay right now. I can scale this and slide it, and I'm in GPU acceleration. However, if I come down to CPU only mode, I've already made mention of this, in software only mode, things are a little bit different. We're seeing that the top gets chopped off. That should not be happening. This is once again a bug with Premiere Pro. This was in there with Premiere Pro CS 4.0. Adobe's kind of in a little bit of a pickle right now, as you can see. Some things work better with the Mercury playback engine in software mode. Some things work better in hardware mode. Back when I had Premiere Pro CS 5.5, I didn't have any of these problems. I don't see how Adobe can be at NAB 2016 releasing new features when they've got bug issues that have been in there since Premiere Pro CS 4.0. I'm really getting a little bit ticked off of all the bugs that keep, you know, getting introduced with newer releases of Creative Cloud. Adobe may want to scrap the Mercury playback engine, get rid of CUDA technology, get rid of OpenCL, and just go back to the OpenGL. I think that's what After Effects uses.